Okay, time to make another beer kit. Take a little break from the all grain today. I'm gonna make a True Brew Oktoberfest. Now, I made this before and it turned out absolutely fantastic. It's a partial extract kit. You get liquid malt extract and dry malt extract, and a half a pound of specialty grains, 2 ounces of Liberty hops, some priming sugar, some bottle caps, and some cheap Mountain's yeast. And you also get a hop sack or a grain bag instructions. Now I'm going to show you how to tweak this kit a little. It was the last time I made this, I tweaked it a little. First of all, instead of the Mountain's yeast, I used Saft Lager 23 because an Oktoberfest is generally a lager. And the 8 ounces of specialty grains, I ended up adding 8 ounces of Crystal 20, and I already have a reusable hop bag, so I'll just put this in my stash of other Muslim sacks. Any instructions? I don't really need them anymore because I don't use the stovetop method. I just normally just do the full 6 gallon wort boil. So I'm going to show you exactly how I did it before, and it'll turn out great for you. And so let's get started on this. Okay, ended up crushing the grains with my Corona grain mill here. It looked great. And I got this reusable grain bag, or a hop sack, whatever you use it for. I just use it for specialty grains. I've used this for quite a long time. So let me get these grains in the bag, and then we'll go to the next step. Okay, first we want to get our water into the turkey fryer, my boil kettle. Let me give you a shot of the inside here. See this? It's all completely well seasoned. You don't want to scrub down the pot after each boil. All I do is wipe mine down with a sponge and rinse it out. This is exactly what you want. This is an aluminum pot. Don't want to scrub it out. Just give it a wipe down with a sponge. It's fine. So I'm going to add roughly 4.5 gallons of water. And then we'll start heating it up and steep the grains. Okay, I got the flame going. Now, you don't have to wait to get to the water to 155 degrees to steep your grains. So I like to get started right away. It's not going to hurt nothing. And I made this out of a PVC valve to hold the grains in place. So I just wrapped this around it. So, and just hang it on the edge. Now I just let them suspend there. You don't want them sitting on the bottom. This way I could bob it up and down. So we'll let this go. Get it up to 155 degrees. Turn down the heat, and then I'll set the timer for 30 minutes, and then we'll steep them for 30 minutes. Okay, we've reached 155 degrees, and don't forget to adjust your control valve here and lower the heat so you can maintain 155 degrees without really going over it. So we'll give it a couple more bobs. Got a nice color, nice aroma. And we'll set the timer for 30 minutes and we'll be back. Okay, in the meantime, start heating up a gallon of water. For our sparge water. Okay, we all know you don't go over 170 degrees. I go around 168 just to be on the safe side. And then we'll sparge our grains and then we'll start to boil. Now we got my 168 degree sparge water and we'll just sparge the grains and rinse them off. Oh yeah, you're getting all the color out of it now. Oh yeah, it's clear. Okay, I'm gonna let's set this aside to drain, and then we'll get it to a boil. We'll be back. Okay, it's just about to get started on the boil. So what I want to do, we got 2 pounds of dry malt extract. I'm going to add just a little bit, maybe a cup. Because I'm going to end up boiling this for the full 60 minutes, then add all the extracts at the end. So I'm just going to add a little bit. Make sure there's no boilers. Yep. Yeah, that's enough. Because this stuff's been boiled already, you don't need to boil it again. The instructions say to boil it first, but you don't have to. I didn't the last time I made this. So what I'm going to do, when this gets started to a rolling boil, then I'll add the hops, and then we'll boil it for 60 minutes. Then we'll flame out and add the rest of the extracts, including the can of liquid malt extract. So I add the first ounce of Liberty hops. Man, that's really bright green. And the second ounce of Liberty hops. Get all that hop sediment in the beer, or in the wort. Try to push it down a little. Now this is all the hops that came with the kit, and it said to add it at the beginning, and that's it. No aroma or flavoring hops. Let me get the timer started for 60 minutes. Trying to push this down. Okay, that'll eventually go down by itself through the boil. I'll keep pushing it periodically. So, we'll be back. Okay, all the hop sediments is all swirling through the beer now. Boiling nice. So, while we're waiting, we'll indulge in a homebrew. This is a summer Hefeweizen that I made. It's an all grain. It's only about a week and a half old in the bottle. So, let's see how it is. I know this is the wrong glass for a wheat beer. And we'll get the yeast sediment on the bottom. Alright. Not too shabby. I don't know if you can see the carbonation. It's just cascading. Use 5 pounds of two row and 4 pounds of wheat. Oh yeah, I used a White Labs. There it is. Yeah, you can see that now. I used White Labs Hefeweizen yeast, and I highly, highly recommend you using that if you make a wheat beer or a Hefeweizen. This is very refreshing. It's only a week and a half old, and look at the carbonation. Now it's a little harsh. Yeah, but after a couple more weeks, it'll calm down and mellow out. I used 1 ounce of Sriracha Ace hops. I don't know if you ever heard of that, but it's grown in Japan, and it gives off a nice lemongrass flavor to the beer, which is perfect for a Hefeweizen. So let me finish enjoying this and get back to the brew. Talk to you later. Okay, this is why you want to keep a spare propane tank ready. Because one just ran out, hook up another one, and you don't miss a beat. Just a little trick. Okay, your 60 minutes is up. Now let's add the extracts. You can see how much it boiled down. So we'll leave this room for the extracts. But I have too much of a volume, or else it won't fit in the carboy. Just add this stuff at the end of the boil. I used to do the stovetop method and boil everything, and this stuff does not need to be boiled at all. So add it at the end. You're gonna have a much better flavor in your beer and better color. And it's clumping up, but it's the wort's hot enough that it'll melt it all in. Get it all out of the bag. And the reason why I only added like a cup at the beginning is for the hops to have a little bit of gravity to cling onto during the boil. Okay, that's the dry. Let's open up the can. Okay, I had this sitting in hot water for like a half hour. Let's thin it out. Stir it in good. Don't let it stick to the bottom, even though the flame is out. Still plenty hot. Smells fantastic now. And I think the volume is perfect. Okay, let me get some hot water, rinse this out, and I'll get the wort chiller in there. Okay, we got our sanitized wort chiller. Turn the water on. Okay. And this will take around 20 minutes. Then we'll get it in the carboy, pitch to yeast. Okay, we finally got it cooled down. Took a lot longer than 20 minutes. And we get some nice aeration going on. It's good for the yeast. Okay, we're done filling it up. Dry funnel and add the yeast. I'm going to put it in dry. I usually rehydrate the other yeast I use, the Sathale 0405. But I don't know, this is a lager yeast, so I'd hate to screw it up by putting it in hot water or warm water. So I'll just put it in dry. And I have a sanitized spoon here, and just I'm gonna stir it up inside. Get it nice and wet. Okay, that sanitized towel on there. I'm gonna get this upstairs and then we'll put the airlock on. Okay, we're good. We're sitting at 73 degrees. What I like to do. Oh, excuse me, I'm out of breath. That thing was heavy. I like to sit this out for a day at room temperature just to get the yeast started. And once I get that thin layer on top, then I'll pop it in the chiller here. Let me show you what I got in here. Right now I have a called a worldwide lager, and this is day number 5, and the airlock's still going. I got 2 ice gallons in there, and it's currently, the fan just went on since I had it open up. It's at 61 degrees. Had it set for 62 to go off, so it's been holding steady at 60 for the last 5 days. So when I get both of these lagers fermenting back to back, and then we're gonna lager them in the fridge in the secondary, and I'll show you how to do that next week. Well, not next week for you, next week for me. This is going to be one video. All right.
Okay. It's been 7 days, so we want to rack this into the secondary. So I got my auto siphon here. Take off the airlock. And we'll drop this in here. That's a half inch auto siphon, so it'll siphon out the beer into the secondary carboy quite quickly. Drop it down all the way to the bottom. Give it a few pumps. And there we go.
And we'll let this go, and I'll finish this up, and then we'll pop it in the fridge and let it lager for 4 weeks. Okay, there she is. Inside the kegerator. I got no kegs going right now. I've been bottling lately to hand out samples to friends and family. So, here it'll sit for 4 weeks, and then we'll bottle it or keg or whatever you usually do. I'm just gonna bottle this one. Okay, thanks for watching, and talk to you later.